about the benefits digital technology can bring to aerospace companies, but are we actually reaping the rewards yet? I'm with Doug Gates from KPMG, who's going to share his insights on this topic. Hi, Doug. Welcome to the show.
Hi. Thank you very much.
So we're hearing this week a little bit that perhaps aerospace companies are not quite as far ahead as they think they are with their digital transformation. What are your views about that?
It is a dichotomy right now. We did a recent report. We found out why the chief executives of many of the aerospace companies, about 90% of them, believe that they are on track to implement digital transformation. Something around the 50 or 60% are saying that they're still at a very tactical level, not a strategic. And where we see is that a good portion of the investment they're making is more on the tactical side and not really on things that are going to redefine their business, which we're seeing in other industry segments. So I do not think that they're gaining really as much as they think they should be at this point.
So when you say redefine the business, what kind of examples are you thinking about?
Yeah, it's where you really, and we did a lot of work in the Industry 4.0 area, and as you start looking at the opportunities, really the broad set of data I can get on my products and my factories provide, how do I take that to transform my business, whether it's to drive new aftermarket services and greater value for their client, or simply to drive more innovation into their products by getting information back on how they're really performing in the field, or even in some cases working with a few companies that are looking at taking their service business and moving into a platform business, much like you would see with like an Uber, et cetera, but packaging it up and moving away from product sales to even a wrapped service model where they sell by the hour and deliver services as part of a bundled platform. That's where we see there's going to be a transformational shift. Most aren't really looking at that operational model change.
So what do you think is holding them back? Is it too complex or is it a skills thing? Or?
Well, again, citing back to that report, 7 out of 10 CEOs simply are frustrated it's just taking too long. And so pressure from shareholders, it's always the rub that you have of long-term investment versus short-term shareholder gain. And it is a long-term investment. It is also, in this competitive shift, these new business models, not a you bet your company so much as if I don't do it, I'm not going to keep up with the other in a competitive landscape. But they just can't really invest in the long term, and it's a real issue right now.
So, what one piece of advice would you give the leaders of these companies to kickstart things?
Yeah, well, actually, I'll give you a few. One is do lay out a strategy. In many cases, we see them throwing technology at the problem and investing heavily, but not with a grand scheme of the strategy and the business benefits. Two, stick to it, communicate, involve your shareholders, involve your customers, involve your suppliers. So develop something that's and involve your employees. So a broad communication plan and get started. Some simply are waiting on the sidelines, thinking it's going to come to them, and it won't.
Excellent. Thank you, Doug.
You're welcome.
To follow the digital transformation in the future and for all our other aerospace news, subscribe to wearefin.com.